Hello everyone, HPI Guys Model Workshop here with a vintage model kit review. I did a vintage model kit review a couple days ago and you guys said you liked it, so we're going to have some more. This kit, the minute you see the box, reminds many of us of our childhood. Right here, this a monogram NASCAR kit from the 80s screams to me being a kid on Sunday afternoons in the living room with my dad, with a TV tray. We picked up one of these kits at Kmart or, you know, Dale's Super Value. The grocery store even had model kits back then. Every place had model kits. The drugstore, the grocery store, the hobby store. And they weren't much. They were, you know, $5 to $6. Not a lot of money at all. And, you know, it just, I can't say it enough. These kits, and the reason I like collecting these kits, and I do build some of them, don't get me wrong, these aren't all shelf queens, just the ones that are more rare that I find. But if I find multiples, which a lot of these are still available, you go on eBay, you go to resellers, you go to old hobby stores with old stock, and the Monogram and AMT and Ertl NASCAR kits are still very abundant out there. The more rare ones are going up in price, so grab them when you see them. But there's still a big market out there for them. Places like Mike's Decals will make new decals for them so you can actually complete your model correctly. Everybody knows the drivers from back in the day. This car right here was driven by Lake Speed. I think so. The decals have faded quite a bit for the name, and it's blurred out on the top here. And they don't even mention it in the instruction manual for the name. I don't think they wanted to pay the licensing to mention his name in the manual. Licensing was a lot different back then. You know, nowadays, God, try to find a kit with all these different sponsor names on it. They're going to charge you a fortune. Back then, the companies were proud to have their names on models that kids were building and adults were building because they knew it was free advertising, but that's all changed. And that's why it's hard to see NASCAR kits. Plus the fact that when a driver had a car like this, it probably stayed this way for the entire season. Every time they built them a car, they would paint it up the exact same way. Nowadays, because of the vinyl graphics they can put on cars, they can change graphics every single race, and it's merely impossible for the model companies to keep up and print, you know, new models with the new decal sheet, new models with the new decal sheet. But there's a niche market out there, and there's a lot of resin manufacturers of NASCAR kits, so don't lose hope. But get yourself on eBay and start buying some of these old NASCAR kits, and just remember your childhood. Now, this is the Wins Kmart Oldsmobile, and Oldsmobile was a good car back then, and that's when General Motors did, you know, have a lot of different cars on the field instead of nowadays where it's just, you know, a few racers and only one style of car between all of them. They all look identical and they just stick a different sticker on the hood to say it's a Ford or a Toyota or a Chevy. Nowadays, they actually, you know, back then, of course, we all know, they all actually pretty much looked like the car that was on the street, just a race version of it. So everybody that had their car out on the track actually looked like the one that you could go to the dealership and buy for the most part. So let's take a look at all the cool stuff that's in this childhood memory blaster box of awesomeness. First, we'll take out all the paper goods in the box, and those are them right there. And in every Monogram box was the wish list, the giant wish list for every month, all the kick-ass stuff that was going to come out that year. And you'd look at this, and you'd check off everything, and you'd take this to the store with you, to Kmart with you, to Sears with you, and you'd find all the stuff. You can see all the cool NASCAR racers, the jets, the sprint cars. That's something they hardly make anything of nowadays, for sure, is sprint cars. But back then, you could find all different kinds of models. And this, of course, is from 1988, so we're looking at 26, soon to be 27 years, you know, going back in time for this kit. Here's the decal sheet. Beautifully done. The decals were always one of the most fun parts of the kit because it had real names that you recognized. And I love that old style Kmart logo with that red and teal. I just think that's sweet. As you can see, unfortunately, over the years, the white decals have faded to almost nothing. I don't think you'd really even be able to see them, even with a dark background. So if I were to build this one, I would just have to find some aftermarket kits that could supply me with what's missing in the white, which would be, I'm pretty sure, I can just barely see, but that should be, for the back of that car, that should be a Delco battery logo. And then right underneath there, those shiny ones are the driver's names, Lake Speed. And the numbers look pretty good. The numbers you could paint underneath and then put on, and the white would stand out more than enough. The great contingency stickers, back when it was called Winston Cup. wasn't named after a phone company. It was named after Manly Tobacco Products. So that's pretty sweet. I get really excited when I was opening this and getting, you know, ready to show you guys everything. Here's your standard blown out monogram manual. Just one large piece of paper calls out building the beautiful stock car engine, your roll cages, your chassis pan with your transmission, your rear end, your bracing on there. You know, everything is done just the way we remember it. And of course, they get you the decals, where to put them, and then they advertise some more of their cars, because the minute you got done building one of these, you had to go out and get another one. The plastic that's in the box. These kits are known as being good kits, so we're not going to have any bad surprises here. There is a beautiful chrome tree, and this is the kind of chrome that I love to see when they made it. I don't think a lot of kits make this anymore, but for a while there, you could get this in a satin chrome. And I wasn't even sure what kits had it. Usually you could tell if a kit had chrome wheels on the box, steel wheels, that they were going to have this satin style chrome inside. Otherwise it was going to be a really shiny chrome. And those are fine, but this to me looks more realistic as metal. Far more realistic. I don't think that if you got out the silver paint or the all clad, you'd do any better of a job than the factory did. Especially on them gorgeous wheels. Look at those bad boys. Those are stock car wheels right there, guys. The intake there. And more engine parts. Valve covers with their spark plug heat shields. Radiator. Just eat up the nostalgia. The air cleaner. Hood pins. Nowadays, you want hood pins, you got to go photo etched. But those look really nice. For back in the day. I really wish they re-released these. I know they have the molds. They can't bullshit me. And pardon my French, but they can't. I know they have these molds because the companies always claim they get rid of molds. And then 30 years down the road, they re-release it. So I know they have these things hidden somewhere. I just think they don't want to pay the licensing for the decals. So what I think they should do is just re-release the kits as they are in the plastic and let the aftermarket decal guys settle it. And I bet you they'd sell millions of them. These are the tires. Everyone knows these tires. There's no hiding these tires. They needed sanding, but they were going to be NASCAR slicks anyway, so that wasn't a big deal. You just sand them crossways to get the seam off, and then you sand them directional so that they actually look like tires. With the big, beautiful Goodyear Eagle lettering on there. Real easy to paint up with a gel pen, and other hobbyists have built these with wheels, tires like this, and they'll show you. You can go all over YouTube, Classic Plastic 101, and check out how to use a white gel pen to letter tires, and they'll come out looking just great. Clear parts. Now, clear parts are hard to get in good condition for these kits. And this one, the clear parts are just about mint. So I don't want to jack with those. When we get done here, they're going right back in their little protective bag and then into a sandwich bag on top of that. Because I don't want this to get scratched. Because once these are scratched, you're SOL. You're not going to be able to duplicate the detail, the rivet detail, and the crossbar decal on a piece of acetate very easily. Let's move on here. Let's go to some of the white plastic parts. We've got chassis and roll cage suspension parts. All nicely done on these kits. And since this was new, almost zero flash, just a very little bit. But they really took pride in these kits back then. They knew that the race car, you know, driver was going to be getting his share of the money and the sponsors when they built these for the license. So they wanted to make them look pretty good. And they knew people weren't going to buy them if they were that hard to put together. But you could slap one of these together if you just wanted to do the decals and didn't want to paint it up. You could build one of these in a weekend. And I know I'm guilty of that when I was a kid. I'd think about painting it. I'd start painting parts here and there, and I'd say, oh, to hell with it, and I'd just throw it all together. You can see that. Nice detail on the chassis there. A super detailer's dream were these NASCAR kits. You could really get involved and really make them look nice. We've got that sweet NASCAR motor there. Check it out. Two halves. Your front suspension. Fans, belts, pulleys. Fire extinguisher. Radiator shrouds, cylinder heads. All beautiful detail parts. Exhaust. Rear end. Look at that. Even the detail on the front of the pumpkin. Steering wheel. Shocks. More suspension. and your headers. A lot of guys simulate those headers with solder because they aren't the sharpest things, but a little bit of painting, a little bit of interior sanding to separate things. You can make them definitely look serviceable. They are kind of hidden once you put it all together anyways. And the last actual parts tree is this one right here. That's going to have your wheel backs. That's going to have your trunk detail, your seat. They actually kind of use similar to a real seat back then. They weren't those super custom racing seats that keep the guys safe today. They were pretty safe cars, but they weren't anything like they are now. Good looking hood on there with insets for your hood pins so that it would just look perfect when you put those in there. They'd look so real. You can just take a look at the rear deck. Inside firewall with the tunnel. Even your pedals were separate and look really nice. So the major part of the kit coming up here is, of course, the Oldsmobile body. And that's a stunner right there. That looks absolutely beautiful. Great molding on that. Looks just like the Cutlasses that they had on the street. Just the race version. No flash, no issues. You can work on the suspension a little bit to get the kit to drop down just like it does. These sit a little high sometimes. You can work on the suspension to get it to hug right over the top of the tires like it would on the track. You can see the detail in there for the gas cap. Trunk, where you put your spoiler. Just nicely done by Monogram. These kits are a nostalgic trip, and I'm glad you guys watched through the whole thing with me. And I hope that inspires you to, if you don't have any in your stash, to go pick up some old NASCAR kits and build them and enjoy them, or just collect them and remember those great drivers back then like Lake Speed and Cale Yarbrough, Richard Petty from the 80s. That's when he was in some of his prime years, where the, you know, 80s, 70s, 60s. The 80s, he started to fade out a little bit, 90s through there. But he was still a great guy. And this just will bring back a lot of memories for any plastic model builder, because everywhere you went, there were NASCAR kits, especially from Monogram. So thanks for watching this little nostalgic vintage trip, and we'll see you at the next review.